Hello, welcome to session 5 of PHS 318, which is titled Public Administration in Ghana. In this session, we will seek to understand the history of the civil service in Commonwealth Africa, and that includes Ghana. We will look at the composition, structure, and function of the civil service in Ghana. And then thirdly, we'll look at the challenges of the civil service in Ghana. So topic one, history of the civil service in Commonwealth Africa. It is said that the civil service in Commonwealth Africa was to consolidate Britain's colonial administration. In other words, the civil service was established during the colonial era so that Britain will be able to maintain her power on her colonies. What are some of the effects? The effects include the fact that the civil service was not oriented and structured to prosecute rigorous development-related agendas. As a result of the fact that the civil service was established to consolidate Britain's colonial administration, issues such as road construction, construction of hospitals, construction of school buildings, and general services delivery were not objectives that were taken by the civil service. The civil service at that time had two main objectives. These include collection of revenue and maintenance of law and order in the colony. The civil service at that time had the following branches. One, the provincial commissioners, who were generally responsible for the supervision of activities in their local government. We also have the district commissioners, who are responsible for the welfare and good order of their district. There was also the police and the treasury. Therefore, we say that the civil service that existed during colonialism was a four-structure civil service. The pursuit of socio-economic development as a major objective is quite a recent phenomenon. As I mentioned to you earlier, the civil service during colonialism was not established to achieve important objectives in service delivery. Financial administration was based on simple accounting of revenue and expenditure and the balancing of the budget. Therefore, the initiative for promoting agricultural development came from missionaries, particularly in the case of Ghana. And then also, social services such as health and education initially was not the direct concern of the civil service. This partly explains the reason why most of the senior high schools in Ghana are missionary-based schools, because the civil service was not focused on achieving such social services. Not much attention was also paid to staff development. Lip service was paid to the idea of appointing Africans into the civil service. And so we had a civil service system that was only filled with expatriates who were delivering social services, and they were not interested in what happened to the colony, because achieving social services was not part of their main objective. Therefore, independence and subsequent exodus of expatriates left grave crises. When Ghana and other African countries achieved independence, there were no human beings, there were no qualified people to fill the offices that were left within the civil service. Now, the racial structure of the civil service could not be immediately dissolved after independence in most African countries. So what is the ultimate result? We have a civil service that is still struggling to rid itself of the negative colonial footprints to focus on dealing with the modern complexities of administration. Topic 2, the composition, structure, and function of the civil service in Ghana. According to the 2015 Annual Performance Review of the Civil Service, Ghana's civil service comprises the following: 24 ministries, 3 extra ministerial organizations, 24 departments, and a staff strength of 14,286 comprising men and women. In terms of structure, we have structure by post, structure by class, and the professional class. The structure by post comprises the following. We have the head of service, the chief directors of all the different ministries, as well as directors and heads of departments. And structure by post, we have the administrative structure, the professional or technical structure, and then the executive structure. The clericals and the clerics and the laborers fall under the professional structure. What are some of the functions of the civil service in Ghana? They are responsible for initiating and formulating policy options for consideration of the government. Mind you that I mentioned earlier on that the civil service comes directly under the executive arm of government. So in terms of policy formulation, the civil service acts in that manner, assisting the executive arm of government not only to design public policy, but then also to implement public policy. The civil service also initiates and advises on government plans. They also implement government policies. What are some of the challenges of the civil service in Ghana? That is our topic three. There is a challenge of inadequate staffing in terms of the right mix of skills and numbers. There is a decline in the level of training offered to civil servants. The poor conditions of service and low salaries. We have a civil service that does not pay the personnel well, and so a lot of people are not motivated to work at their optimum best. There is insufficient budgetary cover for the operations of ministries and departments, as well as inadequate tools and logistics. To conclude this session, we argue that the history of the civil service in Ghana dates back to the colonial period, when the service was established to consolidate the colonial administration of Britain. The service performed two main functions. These are maintenance of law and order and revenue collection. In contemporary Ghana, the civil service formed part of the executive arm of government with direct responsibility for implementing government policies. It is structured along three main lines, namely structure by post, structure by class, and the professionals. What are some of the critical challenges that confront the civil service of Ghana? These include poor remuneration, inadequate working tools, and logistics. With this, we come to the end of session 5. Get ready as we move to session 6.